to trust her in social situations, seem tense when friends come to the door. Sometimes she'll try to lunge if she thinks they're not friendly. Not being able to take her out of the house, anywhere near any other dog, anything she might perceive as a threat. If she's not under control, as soon as she's outside, if she sees something across the street, down the block, whatever, you know, she'll go after it. She doesn't get to have fun, we don't get to take her places, and then also, just afraid she's gonna attack a dog and we'll end up having to put her down. And I want Kai to be able to feel comfortable walking her and not feel like you've gotta have like 140 pounds of muscle ready to hold her back.
So really this is a dog that I had to handle all the time because I couldn't trust Kai to take her out. I didn't trust the dog around Kai, especially if he got into challenging situations. And it wasn't that it was a risk to have her around other dogs, it was a certainty that she would react and try to attack any other dog that came within 30 yards of her. It meant a lot of social isolation. It made the social aspect of having a dog a complete drag because you couldn't go near other people, you couldn't have a conversation. All the focus had to be on the dog, keeping Jovi out of proximity of other dogs. Had to walk her in a closed baseball field, things like that. That was really what the problem that we wanted to solve. And I think Lauren is right. There was always a risk that if she got out of control, or if I wasn't really looking in that key moment when something would happen that's unexpected, something would happen and you know, it would create some kind of liability for us, or she'd have to be destroyed or both. I just love it that we were able to walk her through the market. That's just tremendous. So just even the way she's walking around other dogs here, not just that she does that and behaves, but she doesn't even seem to be under any pressure. Psychological pressure you can see immediately when she would get around other dogs. Even if she saw a damn dog on the other side of a river or something, she'd start to just be a complete maniac.
You're pretty much, you know, at the market today, around lots of other dogs, and I mean, her hair didn't even stand up and step once or twice. She didn't even have a reaction. Dialogue with Mike, me, Kai, who's 10, Meg, who's not here today, but who's, you know, about to turn 18, work at different levels with people wherever they're at and whatever the questions are. Taking the time to do it over and over again with us and giving us feedback and just being totally on top of it.
Some of the techniques are so simple. Just when they're shown you, you realize, you know, I was kind of doing some of that stuff before, but this is so much more systematic and consistent. Spatial pressure was very nice, just to see that in action, how it works.
Having them on heel, further behind you, was not an idea I was familiar with at all. It makes a lot of sense, especially for dog shows. I think she'll be so much happier, too, because now she understands when, you know, what she's supposed to do. She can relax most of the time, you know, be in a space where she's not just constantly scanning the environment.